So we're back again, guys, and this is a kind of an interesting question I asked in the other video. So I go through the demographics of this channel, and basically it's 95% male, 5% female. And my question is, why are you, since why are so many girls not into cryptocurrency? And a discussion I've had with some of my female friends, they go on YouTube for nails, makeup, that kind of stuff, not investing. So why are you so into crypto?
Well, first, we did have other female cryptocurrency people, crypto chicks, that didn't end well. It was a whole Bitcoin drama. But I was rooting for her because I really thought she was hot and I liked her videos, but that didn't end well. Bad for her, but I hope she makes a comeback at some point and hopefully it was a better
life. You can't replace her? I'm really not telling you that. We're going to get you a channel. You're replacing her, but go ahead.
Let's see. I'm looking on my... and I'm going to collect the interest and play with it. No, I don't think I want to replace her. I just want to be myself. Well, I don't know. I just like, I'm a geek, you know, like, I don't think many people get me. Like, I'm stuck like in my own category. I'm a geek. I was always into numbers, but I didn't want to be a math teacher because, and I knew I wanted to have like, you know, a good, successful life. And I didn't want to be a math teacher because I thought like there isn't much money to be made in teaching unless you get PhD and et cetera. So I became an accountant, but then I realized like 9-to-5 job is not for me. And so that's why I was always interested in like how people make money, you know, quick in a short time. Amount of time, and that's what brought me into cryptocurrency. And I grew up in culture where savings were important, you know, and because I grew up in the 90s where Soviet Union fell apart and economy was doing really bad, and early on I realized if you don't save up money, you know, there will never be enough money because it's very easy to spend. And that's why I was always into saving and investing, because I always wanted to make sure that when I get older and can't work anymore, I have savings. You know, and a lot of people here forget it because I'm an American, because I became an American, I got naturalized. But a lot of people who grew up here, they haven't seen what it's like to have a really bad economy when there's shortages of food, shortages of things, you know. That's why that will scare you and you will be into savings and investing and stuff like that.
Another thing I want to ask you, and like I said, we probably were going to make a second video on this, is that you're an entrepreneur, which once again, it's very rare for females. And another thing that I've noticed, and maybe it's because I'm in Orange County, California, where the divorce rate is super duper high. There's a lot of attractive females that do not want to work or do not want to make their own income. They would rather just find a significant other. So this is a good discussion. Yeah, because like you're the complete opposite of that. You're, you know, you're self-educated.
I wouldn't say, yeah, I'm a complete opposite. Like, I do get those comments because I do have an older boyfriend and I always dated older guys because that's what I was and still am attracted to, even though that's fluid and changes. But, you know, everybody just assumes that I'm a sugar baby and whatever, and that I have everything paid for. And unfortunately, that's not the case. You know, I still have to make my own money and pay my own health insurance. I don't have a rich significant other. I'm not married to my boyfriend, even though he's well off. I just was brought up like to rely on my own. It doesn't make me feel good about asking somebody, can you please give me some money to do something? I just can't go out and be shopping with somebody's money who is working hard, you know? I don't know. Maybe at some point if I'm married and like, I don't, and we definitely have enough money, but what is enough money? Like, I want to ask you, what do you think is enough money to like not work?
That's a good question. But the main thing I want, because I plan on hopefully having kids, is I want a daughter that wants to be like you. Like, I want a daughter that is going to pay attention to investments, that in her mindset, she wants to out earn her significant other. Now, obviously if she meets someone that's super duper successful, that's great. But I don't want her to ever just be like, okay, you know, my significant other is going to take care of me and I'm going to cook and clean or do nothing, go to the gym and do Pilates. So, we're going to go into more of this. I think this is really interesting and that way we can kind of talk about this more, but, I do want that mindset. If there are other females, hopefully you guys, you know, makeup and
you gave the best advice. Yeah, you gave the best advice. Don't spend money on stupid shit. You said that in multiple videos, and I was like,
so we'll talk about it.
It's so true.
Yeah, we're gonna talk about this. So let's talk about this on the next video. We'll go into that. So thank you guys for watching, and we will both talk to you guys very soon.